So I have this camping chair that I absolutely love. It's super lightweight and it breaks down into a nice tight bundle. Unfortunately, on my last trip, I broke my favorite chair. See, one of the legs got stuck in the ground, and when I went to pull it out of the ground, I heard a snap. Never good. Underneath this cap, there's supposed to be an insert that holds the bungee onto the leg, but unfortunately, that pole is just filled with dirt. So what I'm thinking is, if I look at one of the other legs, and I create a 3D model of this insert using the free version of Onshape, maybe I can 3D print a replacement and save my favorite camping chair. All right, so I've got this tube here. You can see that I cleaned out all the dirt that was stuck in there. I've got the physical part that I took off of that other leg of the chair. So let's get into it and try to model this thing up in the free version of Onshape. So I think it makes sense to create this thing as a revolve in Onshape. And I think some of the key dimensions are going to be the diameter here where the insert goes down into that tube, as well as the diameter of the cap itself. So it looks like those dimensions are about 15.2 and 17.6. The remaining dimensions on this thing I can probably be a little looser with, but those two dimensions are going to be critical. And I've really got to make sure I get those two dimensions correct. So I'm gonna start out here on the front plane of this model, and I'm gonna create a center line so that I can generate some doubled dimensions, which are really helpful when you're creating revolved features in Onshape. Next, I'm gonna create a cut extrude, which will act as a pocket for the knot of the bungee cord. Finally, I'm gonna create a cut extrude up top, which will allow the bungee cord to pass through this insert and down into the leg of the camping chair. Okay, and I think that looks pretty good. It looks like I got a pretty good match here to this replacement part that I'm trying to create. I'm pretty happy with this thing, and I'm ready to send this over to the 3D printer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just go down here to the bottom of the screen to where it says Part Studio, and I'm going to do a right mouse button on Part Studio and choose Export, and then I'm going to choose to export this as Camp Chair Insert Part, and we're going to export this to STL. And when I choose export, that's gonna actually download that STL. Now I can bring up my 3D printing preprocessor and I can just drag and drop that STL right from Onshape directly into my flash print preprocessor. I'm gonna rotate this thing so that it's pointing up and add some supports. And I think that looks pretty good. Let's start slicing this thing. And now we can see what this is gonna look like and we can send this over to the 3D printer. So the slicer estimated this print would take about 30 minutes, and it was pretty much spot on. I used PLA as the material and an infill of 25%, and hopefully that will hold up for the long run. The supports broke away really easily, and when it was done, I was really happy with how this part looked. But I wanted to test this in the shop before I took it out to the field. So here's the pole, which is the leg of the camping chair, and oh yeah, so satisfying. That just fits right in there. I think this is gonna work great. So we go out to the field with the original part and the 3D printed part. I'll start with the original part and put that into the original leg. We can see here that knot fits down into that pocket of the original part. So far so good. And now to feed this other bungee cord through the other leg, I use some gaffer's tape on a long wooden dowel and just kind of push the bungee cord all the way through the leg. Then I remove that tape. And now I'm taking that knot of the bungee cord and pushing it into that pocket that we drew up in Onshape. Here it is from a different angle. You can see that that knot is in that pocket that we had drawn up in Onshape, and it just really fits in there nicely. I think this is gonna work great. And oh yeah, such a satisfying sound. And then remember, we've got these feet that we're gonna be putting on the bottom of the leg, and I think that's also gonna help to protect that PLA. And here I am at the end of a hard day, testing out my work. The chair is holding together. Here you can see I'm giving it a solid vibrational test and nothing is falling apart. And that is how you can use the free version of Onshape to save your favorite camping chair.